You want to know how I know it's almost robbery week? Because I am starting to get very confident against Ohio State. I am starting to not care about their prolific offense, the way they can razzle and dazzle you on the field. I am not concerned. Well, I'm a little concerned. But at the same time, 59-31, I bet the Ohio State fans, because I've given them so much praise all year long, I bet they're thinking, Ray's going to do it again. We won by 28. We just stomped the team that beat Michigan State by 28 points, by 4 touchdowns. I know he's going to have nothing but good to say. You know what? I don't. I really don't. That pass defense of yours and that run defense of yours at times is not that good. It's not that good. I'm feeling pretty confident. Your defense has a lot of miscommunication, a lot of issues, and we're going to get into it. Yeah, your offense can score. They can score in bunches, but guess what? Michigan's not going to let y'all fly all over the place. Again, this is not Don Brown's defense. I want you to know, this is not Don Brown's defense. We're going to keep guys in front of us better than what we have in the past. We're going to convert third downs on offense a lot more than what we have in the past, and we're not going to crap our pants in the moment the way that Nebraska and Purdue have done for you these last 2 weeks. Purdue this week literally lost the game in the first quarter and early into the second quarter. They're out here shanking punts. The punt goes for like 12 yards. That's as good as a turnover. They're out here fumbling handoffs. That's as good of a turnover, because it is a turnover. They're out here making mistakes on kickoff returns, giving you the ball inside the red zone. I mean, this moment was too big for Purdue, but it's not going to be too big for Michigan. Ohio State better clear some things up, and they better clear some things up in a hurry, because we'll be at home, we'll be ready to play, and we're not going to give you the game. Ohio State runs a very complex offense. That showed. That is definitely a concern of mine for sure. Man, there's some plays that I saw against Purdue that I was like, wow, no wonder their secondary looked lost in the moment. But at the same time, I trust Michigan's defense more than I do Purdue's. Purdue just basically let your guys go free. There's going to be big plays. There's always going to be big plays if you're Ohio State. But I foresee Michigan's defense playing much more like Nebraska or Penn State did, and really making you earn it and making CJ Stroud, the young buck, earn it. Purdue gave it away. They gave it away on the defensive end. Like I said, Ohio State secondary, they're bad. They're bad. They're not Michigan State bad, but they're not that good. I feel very confident that Michigan is going to run and or pass all over Ohio State. They're going to have their hands full. And I'm going to tell you, I'm going to get into it with the Michigan State-Ohio State preview. Michigan stands a way better shot than Michigan State. You know, a lot of these Ohio State fans, half the reason why I'm acting like this is they're in the comments just saying, well, we beat Rutgers by this, and you beat them by this, and we beat so-and-so by this, you beat them by this. You're doing way too much comparison. We lost to Michigan State. Yeah, we stand a way better shot against you guys than Michigan State does. Because Michigan State, if they're going to score, they're going to score quick and in a hurry. Michigan's going to slow you down, make it methodical, and really give a lot of pressure on CJ Stroud, both on the field and in general, mentally. I mean, he's going to have a ton of pressure when limited possessions are coming his way. That is Michigan football. That's what you guys are failing to see. What you guys keep seeing is low-scoring games, and you're out here balling out, scoring all these points. But if we don't allow you to do that, and I feel confident we won't allow you to do that, you're going to have to play our game. And I don't think that CJ Stroud is going to be as comfortable as Cade McNamara playing our game. I'm starting to feel good. I'm starting to feel great. Maybe it's the Kool-Aid. I don't know. Aiden O'Connell threw for 390 yards, almost 400 yards against your defense. He was 40 for 52. Wow, that is crazy efficient. 4 touchdowns, 0 interceptions. You guys look lost in the moment, and you knew Purdue had to throw the ball. They couldn't do anything but throw the ball. They were down by so much, and you still almost allowed 400 yards and only 12 incompletions. I mean, tell me, what do you think about that secondary? That's not good. That's not good. Those numbers wouldn't be good if you did not know the pass was coming. They are especially bad when you know the pass is coming. And even so, the running backs for Purdue average 4.8 yards per a carry. That's almost 5 yards per a carry. If Purdue can do that, what do you think Michigan can do? I don't know, man. I feel great about this. Yeah, you got guys that can get loose. Garrett Wilson, TreVeyon Henderson, Jaxon Smith-Njigba, they got loose in this game. I imagine they're going to get loose against Michigan plenty of times, and we're going to have our hands full, and we're just going to have to bounce back after we give up the big play. But like I said, minimal possessions, and I feel like we're going to be in pretty good shape, because that's minimal opportunities, and the pressure starts to mount on CJ Stroud, and he starts to feel young, and he starts to realize he's on the road. I mean, a lot of these these times when you guys are in a close affair, you're at home in that situation. A little bit different when you're on the road in the big house. Stroud went 31 for 38 for 361 yards, 9.5 yards per completion, 5 touchdowns, 0 interceptions. Purdue made it easy on him. Just 7 incompletions. This probably statistically, in terms of efficiency, yardage, touchdowns, to interception ratio, probably one of, if not the best game CJ Stroud has played all year long. But again, just the moment was too big for Purdue. They didn't show up from day one. It's easy to play good football when you're up 35-7 right out the gates. And I know you're going to say, oh, Ohio State scored on all these possessions. They had to do something of their own. I don't know. Purdue's just giving you the game. They're handing it to you on a silver platter. They gave it to you inside the 50-yard line 2 or 3 times in the first half. It's wild. Why don't you just give them the game and go ahead and prepare for next week? Miyan Williams, 14 carries for 117 yards. TreVeyon Henderson, 13 carries for 98 yards, 2 touchdowns. They had pretty good days. Purdue couldn't stop the run either. They were just a mess on defense. They just got manhandled. They're not a very good defensive team. They tried to go tit for tat with you on the offensive end, which is not a good idea to do against Ohio State. Again, another reason why I feel like Michigan might be in a better shape. We're not going to try to go tit for tat with you. That's not our game. Either you're going to play our game or we're going to play your game. And so we're going to see. Cade's going to have to convert some third downs, and that's going to have you play our game. If he doesn't convert those, then we're in a heap of trouble. I will admit that. You guys had your 3 big receivers go for 350 yards out of your 361 receiving yards. Only 11 yards outside of your 3 big receivers, Jaxon Smith-Njigba, Garrett Wilson, and Chris Olave, and they had 28 receptions of the 31. And Purdue, if you're playing defense here, you can only let one guy get loose, 2 at the most. You cannot let all 3 guys just absolutely torch you. They had 97% of the production on offense. Jaxon Smith-Njigba had 9 receptions, 139 yards, 1 touchdown. Garrett Wilson, 10 receptions, 126 yards, 3 touchdowns. Chris Olave, 9 receptions, 85 yards, 1 touchdown. I mean, they just balled out. They balled out. One bad thing about Ohio State that I think they should get back to is, because this isn't always going to be the case, maybe Michigan State will allow this because their secondary is terrible, but they have given the running backs passes out of the backfield. Outside of the Nebraska game where TreVeyon Henderson had 6 catches for 44 yards, 3 out of the last 4 games, they are not throwing very often to their players out of the backfield, and Miyan Williams and TreVeyon Henderson can both do a lot of damage in that area. I really think if I'm an Ohio State coach, I'd go back to that and keep the defense honest when we're talking about guarding receivers. All of a sudden, you let the running back slip out. It, as you guys know, has been a concern of mine all season when I'm thinking TreVeyon Henderson out of the backfield on the pass. I imagine they will get back to that, but for now, they are not doing it. But yeah, I had Stompin' Peak, a longtime subscriber, a faithful subscriber, an Ohio State fan. He commented on my Penn State Michigan video, and this is why I'm so crazy right now. He commented on the video and said that was a sloppy game if I've ever seen one, or something to that effect. Come on, man. Come on, Stompin'. What do you see that's sloppy about that game? Both teams had 4 penalties. Both penalty yardage were total less than 30 yards, so that's not sloppy, so I'm not sure what you're talking about. Both teams had 1 turnover. Really, both of the turnovers were forced. I mean, Penn State did the fake field goal, so they had a punter catching the ball, and it was 4th down anyways. It was a field goal, so I don't even know if that's really even a real, what you would call a turnover, but it is on the stat sheet. And then Cade McNamara got strip sacked. I mean, most quarterbacks would fumble in that scenario when a defensive end is crashing down on you like that. I mean, they got around us. It wasn't sloppy. I don't know what you're talking about. The sloppy is what Nebraska's doing, giving up chip shot field goals against you and basically handing you the game on a silver platter, and Purdue just basically crapping the bed in the first quarter. That's sloppy. That's sloppy. Michigan's not going to do that. We got Jake Moody, one of the best kickers in the entire nation. Probably the best kicker in the entire nation. I'm not sure. He's got to be up for the award. He's not going to miss. He's not going to miss those chip shots against you. We got Brad Robbins. He's not going to shake punts. He's a great punter. He's an excellent, experienced punter. We're not going to have any issues there. Special teams, offense, defense, Michigan is a very complete team. We're not going to do you any favors the way these teams have, so you better bring a better effort than what you have over the last few weeks. And I know you're looking at me and you're mad at me and you're like, Ray's talking junk, here we go. Guys, if you haven't been on this channel before, this is what I do. This is what I do. I'm here to entertain. Do I feel good about Michigan's chances? Yeah, they're rising. I really do feel pretty decent about them compared to previous seasons. It's not like last year where we were 35-point underdogs. We got a lot of confidence on our side right now. We're winning games the tough way, and if we make you have to win a game in the tough way, well, we've already seen you against Oregon when you were in that scenario, so would love to see you again at the Big House. We have to bring that game to you and make you get in that situation again. Hey, if we don't, you guys know what I'm going to do. I'm going to eat crow. I'm going to say that we lost and say that we sucked and say that we did this wrong and that wrong. And I'll be here. I'll be here all the time. I'm on here. This is my channel. I'm here all the time. So I'm asking you, when we win, don't leave. Don't leave. Be here. Be in the comments. Tell me congratulations. I'm going to tell you congratulations if we lose. So that's that. I thought I'd have fun with that one because really, honestly, really, you won by 28 and that is impressive, but I know what you guys are going to do. You're going to say, again, we won by 28 against the team that beat the team that beat you. You can go ahead and go down that rabbit trail all you want. For all I care, Florida lost to Alabama by 2 points, but then they're giving up 52 points against the FCS opponent. They're getting throttled by South Carolina. So the transitive property, the hippity-hoppity stuff, it doesn't really work in college football. It's Michigan versus Ohio State. Best versus best, winner wins the Big Ten East as long as you guys and us both take care of business this weekend. And I'm here for it. See you later, guys. Have fun. God bless. Go Blue.